Today we are going to learn some basic functions in Excel like sum, max, min, average and count. So let us first see why do we need a function. So suppose I am writing some numbers here. Okay, and I have to find some of these numbers. So in my previous video I told you how to write a formula in Excel. So if I have to find the sum of these numbers, I will write equal to, I will click on the first cell, it will show you the address of the first cell, click on plus sign, click on the second cell, it will show you the address of the second cell here, that is A2 plus, and so on. So now there are eight cells, so you have to click on the cells one by one to get the sum. So it will be a tedious task if there are more number of values which you have to add. And if you click on these values one by one, it will take a lot of time. So to save this time, we can use functions. So functions are some inbuilt formulas in Excel which you can directly use or apply to your worksheets. So let us first write, I have already written these numbers. Now we will find some of these numbers. So I'm writing equal to sum, open the round brackets, select the range. I want to find some of these values, so I have selected this range. When I select the range, you can see there is a dotted boundary coming on these cells, and inside the bracket it is shown A1 colon A8. Close the bracket. We will use only round brackets for a function. Okay, there are three types of brackets: round bracket, curly and square brackets. We will use only round brackets. Okay, so sum equal to sum A1 colon A10. Here A1 is the starting address of the range, A8 is the ending address of the range. In between we have to use a colon sign to give a range. So colon sign is used when we are giving a range of cells. Press enter. So this will give you a sum of the selected values. Similarly, now if I have to find maximum value in this range, so this is a range of cell, I'm just deleting it. This is a range of cells, and if I have to find maximum value in the range, suppose I write the function equal to max. Max is used to find the maximum value in a given range. Select this range. Okay, A1 to A8 is the range, and to write the range, we write starting address, that is A1, colon ending address, that is A8. Enter. So as you can see in this list, 90 is the maximum value. Similarly, if I have to find minimum value in the list, I will write equal to min, bracket open, select the range, bracket close. Min is used to find minimum value in the given range. Press enter. So as you can see, 3 in this range, 3 is the minimum value. You can just double click on any cell to see what formula is being written in this cell, or you can just click on this, just see this formula bar. This also shows the content of the current cell or the formula written in the current cell. Now next function is average. So I can write average. Now you can see here, for average we have to write average. We cannot write AVG shortcut like we were writing min and max for minimum and maximum function, but for average we have to write full average. We cannot write AVG. Okay, select the range, bracket close, only round brackets need to be used in the functions in Excel, and this is the average value of this range of cells. Now next is count. So what does count function do? Count function is used to count numerical entries in the given range. So if I select these cells A1 to A8 and press enter, it is showing what? 8, because 8 is the, there are 8 numerical entries in this cell. Okay, so I'm just writing minimum, this is average. Okay, so there are 8 numerical entries in this cell. If I change any of these values to a text, like I write hello, now you can see it is showing 7 here, because now 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 numerical values are there. This is the text value which I have entered here, and accordingly the values of maximum and minimum will remain the same, but the value of average has changed. So if I click on 90 and if I change the value of 90 to 96, here you can see the maximum value has changed to 96 now. So as you know, the formula and the functions will recalculate itself when we change any value of the cell range which is given inside it. Now we have made this worksheet. Now we will apply this formula in this worksheet. So in this worksheet we are having name and marks of different subjects. Now if I have to find total marks, I will write equal to sum, open the round brackets, Select the range, English plus Hindi plus Maths plus Science plus SST. So this is range V2 colon F2, close the brackets and press enter. So this is the total marks, this is the formula which we have written. V2 is the starting address, it is the address of English. F2 is the ending address, it is the marks of SST is given in F2. And colon we use to give a range of cells. Place the cursor in the lower right corner, this is called the fill handle. This is a small rectangle here, the small square is here. There. You can place the cursor and scroll it down. The formula will be copied to other cells also. So here the cell address is B3 colon F3. Here we are finding the sum of B4 to F4. Here we are finding the sum of B5 to F5. Okay. So I'm just double clicking on it to see the formula which is being written in the cell. Or you can see the formula written in the cell in the formula bar also. Suppose I have to find maximum in English now. So I can write equal to max. The function for maximum is max. Select the range. Close the brackets. Enter. So 90 is the maximum mark. If I have to find minimum in Hindi, equal to min, open the round brackets, select the range, close the brackets, equal to min, C2 to C5. So 55, 56 is the lowest in Hindi. And similarly, average in Math, equal to average, select the range, close the brackets, enter. So 81.75 is the average marks in Math. Similarly, we can use a count function to count the number of numerical values in the given range.